Liposuction may seem like a quick and easy fix for a lot of people, but how effective is it for weight loss, and what important things should you know beforehand? Hi, I'm Dr. Brian Young, a naturopathic doctor in Toronto. We'll be talking about weight loss surgeries on this channel, so subscribe if you're interested in learning more. Full disclosure, I'm not a surgeon, so I'm not an expert on the actual procedure. Rather, I help to support patients who've had liposuction done by assisting in their post-surgical recovery and long-term weight maintenance. From the experiences of many of these patients, I'm here to talk to you about what you might expect if you decide to get liposuction yourself. Liposuction, also known as lipo, is a surgical procedure that involves the physical removal of fat. It's often done to remove unwanted patches of fat, like belly fat or fat under the chin, or to help improve the curvature of the body, like under the breasts. The standard procedure typically involves poking a blunt needle into the fat layer, pumping in a liquid, and raking the fat loose before sucking out the fat in solution. There are actually a few different ways liposuction can be done, including using lasers or ultrasounds to break up the fat. Whichever method is appropriate for you will be up to your surgeon to determine. The procedure can take a few hours depending on how much fat is removed, and is an outpatient procedure, meaning you'll likely be able to go home the same day after your surgery. Side effects and complications. Some complications are potentially life-threatening, like a risk of fat embolism or blood clots, infections, or heart and kidney problems, so you'll need to be screened properly before getting it done. After your liposuction, swelling, edema, and liquid buildup are very common, and you might need to have the area drained and your bandage dressings changed from time to time, until the area stops producing so much liquid. It also will look and feel all bruised up and usually takes a couple weeks to heal. You might need to wear a compression garment around the area to reduce any body contour irregularities, such as asymmetry, as well as reduce the appearance of any irregular bumpy or wavy textures underneath the skin. Sometimes these problems still appear after healing and need further correction and aftercare. Finding a good surgeon. In my experience, the right surgeon really makes a difference. Many of the side effects and quality control issues with liposuction, such as an uneven distribution of fat being removed and weird textures underneath the skin, as well as more serious complications during surgery, are greatly minimized when liposuction is done by an experienced and properly trained and licensed plastic surgeon and their team. Google searches are not enough, and social media presence can be misleading. You should put in the effort to do your due diligence to find a plastic surgeon that can do your liposuction safely and skillfully. Here are two quick tips I can give. Firstly, make sure your surgeon has all the proper certifications and is actually a plastic surgeon. In Canada, the descriptive term plastic surgeon is regulated. This is different from a cosmetic surgeon, which is a term that is not regulated and can be used by non-plastic surgeons. You can search your doctor's name on the Royal College of Physicians and Surgeons website to make sure your surgeon is actually a member of the Canadian Society of Plastic Surgeons. You can also find other information about your doctor, like disciplinary actions or if their license has ever been suspended and for what reasons. Secondly, consult with a number of different plastic surgeons and ask how often they perform the particular liposuction you want and what their complication rates are, as well as how they might deal with these complications should it occur. Don't just ask about liposuction in general. Ask specific questions about the specific procedure and area, since they all differ greatly. For example, if you're doing an abdominal liposuction, you could ask them how many times they've done it before, or if they've ever experienced a fat embolism, and if so, how it was dealt with. Consider surgeons that are fully certified and trained and are able to answer all your questions in a straightforward and honest manner, without having to beat around the bush or avoid your questions. Is it effective? Liposuction is not meant to be used for weight loss, since the amount of fat typically removed is not a whole lot. Most surgeons stick to a maximum of around 5 liters, which is about 11 pounds of fat, although many procedures typically remove much less. Fat regain is very common, particularly in the abdomen, if a weight maintenance plan was not implemented properly. As a result, many patients who primarily use it to lose weight end up having to undergo liposuction in the same area over and over again. Liposuction is meant to be a sculpting procedure and help to modify the fat distribution of your body. It's not really meant to help you lose weight. What to expect? Although liposuction can achieve some fast results in terms of body shape, it shouldn't be used primarily to lose weight. I recommend that patients first lose weight using other appropriate means, such as following an effective dietary and lifestyle protocol, as well as using any supporting tools or medications, before considering liposuction to further refine their body shape. Because targeted fat loss is not possible through natural means, liposuction may be an option for some patients who have already lost some weight but are unable to target fat in stubborn areas. If you do decide to get liposuction, here are some things you should keep in mind. 1. Fat regain is common, especially around the abdomen. Plan to have a good weight loss maintenance plan or protocol in place after your surgery. It will help to minimize fat regain and maintain your expensive sculpting efforts. If you're interested in the type of maintenance program I use to support weight loss patients, check out our online weight loss program in the description down below. 2. Finding a good plastic surgeon is important. Spend the time to research your surgeon by setting up a consultation to ask them specific questions about your procedure. Avoid just using social media or what you find on the internet, since that information can be misleading and might not be applicable to your situation. Finally, liposuction is quite expensive, averaging several thousand dollars depending on the location and amount of fat removed. If you're spending that much already, my suggestion is that you don't just aim for the cheapest and look to find the right surgeon for you instead. It will help minimize the possibility of complications and improve your satisfaction with the procedure. Let me know in the comments down below if you have any experiences with liposuction you'd like to share. And if you found this video helpful, please leave me a like. As before, I'm Dr. Brian Young, bringing you weight loss info on this channel. Subscribe and hit the notification bell if you're interested in learning more, and share it with someone you know who needs the help.